thorn flesh, that bait you carry around your neck, that you fasted for 40 days and still there? Y'all ain't gonna be home. I believe some of the sisters over here understand what I'm saying. You fasted and prayed and had a prayer meeting and had an overnight prayer at the church and all the saints poured oil on you and prayed. I mean, you got them and still there. Yes. And you asked God, remove this thing from me. But he said, boy, go read about Paul. My grace, my influence on your life is sufficient for you. I'm going to make sure this thing gets done in spite of the devil.
Hallelujah.
Let me close. This kind of stuff takes a whole week to do, you. So, am I teaching y'all? So you have this foundation, you have this apostle. You have to be able, the Bible says some call themselves to be apostle. See, you know when you're around a real apostle, go up close and smell it. If you don't smell smoke, that's no apostle. You got to be able to smell the spirit. Because a true apostle has been burned. A true apostle has been near to death. That want to give up. The world that grows hard. Anybody here know what I'm talking about? Have you ever heard anybody tell you, you ain't good, you ain't never coming back? You ain't coming back from where you at? You can't get it up. How you can get it up? How somebody that you can be preaching the gospel? I don't know about y'all, but y'all pray for me. I don't want nobody preaching to me without a testimony. I don't know what you're a pastor, but I don't want nobody preaching to me without a testimony. If you don't understand me, you can't preach to me. You have no revelation of what's going on in my life. If you don't have no testimony, you can't tell me where God brought you from. Don't tell me where to go. We have this solid foundation. We can't afford to disconnect ourselves from the kingdom. If you're not under the pastor, even if he is not at your church and a pastor, get connected with one. Yes. You need someone in that office, yes, who the Holy Ghost is dealing with for revelation for the,
yes,
kingdom.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
God's not going to violate his program.
Oh,
he's only going to put the revelation, the mysteries, the secrets, my God, they're going to be revealed to the office. It's not so much the man. If the man would be honest, he'd just barely holding on. If the apostle don't really be honest, you know this week you want to quit.
Yeah.
You don't give it no thought that much no more, because you've been doing it for 25 years now. But you know in the beginning. You come to the place where you just accept, if God do what it's not going to get done. Jesus said to the apostle, it is given unto you. Watch this. I'm trying to go here. It is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom. It comes with the office. It's not given to the church. It's given to the apostle. Paul said, let a man count of us as ministers of Christ and stewards over the mysteries of God. God made the apostle that can't take over his mysteries. You are responsible for laying before God and going through the experience. Too many of us are trying to bind the experience we need to go through. You know what? Can I go here now?
Yes, sir.
Listen,
oh,
I love all of y'all, but I don't do for church people.
Yeah.
Don't you sit there acting like you don't have no issues. You acting like that by your church. Don't you sit there and make me start prophesying. I'm not in that office. But don't sit here and look at me like you don't have no issues. Because if you are a living human being, you have some issues. But all the apostles have the spirit that God assigned to them. And here's the key. The enemy uses the spirit to try to stop revelation. But God uses it to give you revelation.
Amen.
May your acquaintance be forgotten. What I'm doing is laying some of your thoughts to rest. See, the truth is, if we stop pretending to you, if we stop acting like we think you want us to act, and that's why we don't have no power, because we're bound by your thoughts. Yes. 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 Yes